Hey everybody, welcome to the channel. My name's Jay Tanner, and today I wanted to talk about The Last of Us Part 2, which was recently released. Full disclosure, I am not playing this game, and I have no plans to, so this isn't a review of it. I'm just giving my thoughts as someone who is actively boycotting the game. The game had several leaks, so whoever leaked it ended up saving me $60, which I really appreciate. It's been 7 years since the original Last of Us was released, and people were really excited for a sequel because this is a really beloved game. Unfortunately, the game didn't exactly live up to those expectations. Spoiler warning for The Last of Us Part 1 and 2, because I'm gonna cover major aspects of the story. The first game ends with Joel rescuing Ellie from the Fireflies, and even though this might not be the right thing to do, we understand why Joel does it. They want to use Ellie to create a vaccine against the infection, but it would also kill her in the process. And because of everything Joel's been through, he can't let that happen, so he kills a lot of the Fireflies in order to save her, although it's up to the player how many die. But it's understandable that this would lead to consequences, and I don't mind this being the focus of Part 2, but the execution was just awful and really does a disservice to the franchise as a whole. Granted, the Firefly's plan probably wouldn't have worked anyway, since we use vaccines against viruses and not fungus, but I digress. I do like how this game starts with Joel telling Tommy what happened. It does a good job at recanting the events of the previous game, and shows that there'll be consequences going forward. I just wish the game could have delivered. The Last of Us 2 features a second playable character, a woman named Abby, the daughter of one of the surgeons that was going to operate on Ellie, and Joel killed, so now she wants revenge on him, which again, would be understandable, but they have her kill Joel off very early in the game, and it's really unceremonious, not to mention a disservice to his character, plus the game's trailers made it look like Joel would be a major part of this game, only for him to be killed off early on. We barely get to see him outside of flashbacks, so them using him so heavily in the marketing was really dishonest. And everything about it was just kind of ridiculous. Most of the opening of the game leading up to Joel's death has a lot to do with relationship drama, to the point where it's kind of ironic that in the first game, Ellie found that diary from before the outbreak, and she was questioning how anybody could worry about things like relationship drama and what clothes to wear, since it was so foreign to her growing up in a zombie apocalypse, only for that to practically be the case here, where she hooks up with a girl who just broke up with her boyfriend, who's also pregnant by him, and everything's pretty awkward. Then they're supposed to meet up with Joel and Tommy, but there's a blizzard, so instead of keeping watch like they should, they decide to get high and hook up. In the meantime, Joel and Tommy come across Abby, and then end up trapped by Abby's group, who proceed to knock out Tommy and then torture Joel. And to add insult to injury, Joel saved Abby's life right before this, because she went to track Joel alone and got in over her head. So if Ellie hadn't been fooling around, she probably could have realized something was off earlier and saved Joel before it was too late. I just think it's weird to have all this relationship drama in a game that's supposed to be about the zombie apocalypse. I get that the main focus of the game is that revenge is bad, but it feels more like it's all just relationship drama with a zombie apocalypse as a backdrop. Compare that to the first game, where things pick up really quickly. It starts off with a quick scene establishing the relationship between Joel and his daughter Sarah, and then we immediately get thrown into the zombie apocalypse, and everything's really high energy and high stakes. And even though we didn't know Sarah long, her death is impactful. Just those few moments we got with her made us care about her. Compare that to Jesse, who dies pretty uneventfully, and then is never brought up again, even though he's the father of Dina's baby. And Ellie's story in the beginning of the game is just her wandering around town talking to people, and dealing with drama. The graphics may be nice, but it took PewDiePie 40 minutes to come across a zombie in his playthrough. In my opinion, that's too long. Plus, you don't encounter a zombie until you're controlling Abby. And even if you don't know the spoilers, there's not really any tension, because the game hasn't given us a reason to care about Abby, not like the way it did with Sarah. All we know about her is that she's looking for someone, and it turns out she's looking for Joel to kill him. It doesn't help that Joel was out of character. All throughout the first game, he was very skeptical and untrustworthy of other people. I get that there's a time skip, but old habits die hard. Joel and Tommy just casually introduce themselves, while on their turf, no less. The first game established that Joel can recognize an ambush, and he's not an idiot, but we're expected to just buy this. Then Ellie arrives only to immediately get captured, and gets to watch while Abby bashes Joel's head in with a golf club, all the while insisting that they stop or she'll kill them. Despite this, for some reason, Abby and her group let Ellie and Tommy go, which seemed like a really stupid thing to do, considering the fact that Tommy is Joel's brother, and Ellie literally kept threatening to kill them, but then they're all shocked when they come back for revenge. Why would they think otherwise? To be honest, I can't help but feel like the only reason why they let them go is because the rest of the game needed to happen. Abby spent all this time tracking Joel to get revenge for her father, and then is shocked when somebody else comes trying to get revenge for Joel, who was a father-like figure to her. This seems like it should have been obvious. But Ellie ends up going on a killing spree, just to get to Abby, only to not finish the job in the end. She ends up deciding right when she's about to kill Abby that murder and revenge is wrong, despite the fact that she murdered so many people before this point. But she couldn't have decided then that revenge was wrong? Now it just feels like this whole thing was a big waste of time. There's nothing satisfying about this ending, and Abby's not exactly a sympathetic character. They keep going on about subverting expectations, but it doesn't really mean anything if the story sucks. I would much rather have a story with an obvious ending, but it was still satisfying, than subverting expectations to make it annoying. I'm not mad that Joel died. What I'm mad about is how it happened. They really did Joel dirty. He should have gone out in a more dignified way. People still talk about Lee from The Walking Dead Season 1. His death was very emotional, and leaves an impact for all the right reasons, while Joel does the exact opposite. There's nothing about his death that makes this worthwhile. Abby beats him to death with a golf club, and then leaves without explaining anything. And to top it all off, another character spits on Joel's corpse, and it doesn't help that this character looks exactly like Neil Druckmann, who is the game's director. Honestly, I couldn't even play this game anyway because I would just keep killing Abby over and over again, and not actually progress in the game. There are a lot of people saying that people who reviewed the game without finishing it don't deserve a right to their opinion, and this is where a lot of the criticism is coming from, but they really shouldn't be shocked that people are DNFing this game. PewDiePie said he wanted to quit the game after Joel died, and a Korean streamer called TV Crank destroyed his copy of The Last of Us 2 after Joel's death scene. Apparently, he recently lost his father and saw Joel as a father-like figure to him. The Last of Us meant a lot to a lot of people, and this game literally spat on that legacy. People shouldn't have to finish a game that they aren't enjoying, or spend money on an experience that they know they aren't going to enjoy. Whether it was from finding out through the leaks or playing until Joel's death and realizing this isn't okay, those opinions are still valid. And the reviews for this game didn't even do it any favors anyway. People saying that they had to recover from it, that it was the Schindler's List of video gaming, these are all red flags. It's 2020, we're all exhausted and we're only halfway through the year, and maybe this wasn't the best time to release this game during a global pandemic, or on Father's Day weekend, just saying. I'm not going to play a game I have to recover from, I have my own problems. And M doesn't need this after everything she's been through. All that would happen is I give Naughty Dog my money, and then I wouldn't have a good time. It's a win-lose situation and I'd be the loser. And of course, people are pretending that the only reason why fans are upset about this game is because of bigotry. Never mind that Ellie was revealed to be gay 6 years ago, and people were still hyped for this game. Besides, this game is pretty sexualized, even if the media doesn't want to admit it. I already talked about Ellie and Dina fooling around while Joel needed them, but there's also a pretty infamous sex scene between Abby and another character named Owen, even though he has a pregnant girlfriend. But who asked for this? This is so weird! Not to mention unnecessary. People were expecting The Last of Us Part 2, not all this weird relationship drama, or really uncomfortable yet memeable sex scenes. But it's really hypocritical because Sony has been censoring Japanese games, yet they allow this in one of their games? But I guess it's okay because it's a different art style? Some consistency would be nice, Sony, because this feels more like Neil Druckmann's self-insert fanfiction instead of a proper sequel to The Last of Us. Why else would they have the character that looks just like him spit on Joel's corpse? Now The Last of Us is just thrown onto the pile of franchises that ended in sheer disappointment. But that's my opinion, what do you guys think? Are you also refusing to acknowledge The Last of Us Part 2 as canon? Let me know in a comment down below. Thanks for watching, I really appreciate it. I'd like to give a shout out to our members, Caleb Nelson, Stutania, Tyrant Carnivore, Adam K, and Shiny Orc Boy. I'd also like to give a shout out to @KanohiKirill on Twitter for this lovely piece of fan art. It's awesome and the cute kitties were a really nice touch. If you enjoyed this video, you can leave a like and subscribe to the channel to see more content like this. And if you want to support us, you can check out our GoFundMe and buy me coffee. Links are in the description. Thanks again, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.